गुड मॉर्निंग एलास मेयर बॉयज़, टुडे वी विल डू अ प्रैक्टिकल बेस्ड स्ट्रिंग प्रोग्राम। लास्ट डे वी डिड वन प्रैक्टिकल बेस्ड स्ट्रिंग प्रोग्राम, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डू अनदर प्रैक्टिकल बेस्ड स्ट्रिंग प्रोग्राम एंड दिस स्ट्रिंग प्रोग्राम विल वी विल यूज़ द स्ट्रिंग टोकेनाइजर कॉन्सेप्ट बैक अगेन सेम एज द प्रीवियस वन। So I'm trying to give a similarity based programs. Most common things of using benefits of string tokenizer so that you can use it while doing the practical program, and as well as the same time you will be rehearsed with how to write the programming code. So as you can see in the screen, there is a question which is present at the ISC 2020, which is this current year. ISC 2020, this current year, question number 3 related to string. So let's solve the same year question and see that how we can solve it practically. And this type of question generally comes every year in the ISC practical. So it will give you an idea of how to perform. Let's look at the question. The question says, write a program to accept a sentence which may be terminated by full stop, question mark or exclamation mark only. The words are to be separated by a single blank space and are in uppercase. So it means that the sentence that the user is giving, it is pre-assumed that it is having single blank space and it is in uppercase, all in capital letter. Perform the following task. Number one, check for the validity of the accepted sentence only for the terminating character. It means we have to check for the full stop, question mark and exclamation mark should be at the end of the question. Sentence, otherwise it will be an invalid input or invalid text. This is one of the common criteria that they give every time when they give any kind of string based question. Let's look to the next point. Arrange the words in the ascending of order of their length. If two or more words have the same length, then sort them alphabetically. So over here there is an ascending order sort, rather two sorting technique we can, two sorting part we will use. First we will sort them according to their length, and then we will sort them according to their, if the length is same, then alphabetically. Last part C, display the original sentence along with the converted sentence. So as you can see in the example, as you sow, so shall you reap. That output is coming as so, both are of actually two letters word, so they have been sorted alphabetically, same as so you reap shall. Okay, so here s, so as s is coming before y, so is first, then you reap shall, r is coming before s. So they have been sorted actually in the form of alphabetical order. So let's look at how we are going to solve this program. To solve this program, the first thing that we are going to do is we are going to make a class like the way we used to do. So let's go to the back to BlueJ Perform. Okay, in the BlueJ platform, the first thing that we are going to do over here is to create a new class, and I'm giving the class name to understanding level, giving as question 3 underscore 2020. So it pointed out that we are doing the question 3 work of 2020 year. Okay, let's open and clear it out. And then I'm increasing the size of the this text, so I'm giving it as 22. Now let's start with the program. I'm going to write first import java dot util dot star semicolon class question 3 same as it is underscore 2020, then public static void main. Now one thing I want to say and point it out over here is it's very important that you understand that this program I'm doing as the same way I did the previous program. So in the previous program I have not used any method while solving it, but what I personally did is that I used the concept of string tokenizer and put the whole thing inside the main part. So here also I am doing the same thing. I am using the only one function and that is main, but I am using the string tokenizer concept along with it. So to do that, first I am writing the scanner class. Scanner sc equal to new scanner system dot in. Once it's finished, I'm asking the user to give me the sentence. So I am writing print ln. Within the bracket, I am writing enter the sentence. Once it is finished, I am writing string sent, where I am accepting my value from the user as sc.nextInt. Once I finished of this part, I am taking some extra variables in case if I need it. If I don't need it at the end, I can just remove it. So I am just taking right now only one extra variable. Now to count the number of tokens or number of words, I'm taking C. Okay. In case if required, I will use more variables. Now I'm writing a string token array and initializing that with string approximate size of 100. This is a size which I am imaginary. So you can give 200 anything, because we are going to at the end deal with the letter C or variable C, which will count how many tokens are actually present inside of it. So let's first pick up the last character and check whether it is a valid sentence or not. So to do that, I am using a char ch equal to send dot char at. So char at sent dot length minus 1, which will pick up the last character, and I will check if ch is equal to full stop or ch is equal to exclamation mark or ch is equal to we have question mark. If all of these things are valid, then we will do our work. So I'm keeping that bracket on and off. Else, the part that we are going to do is that we are going to write invalid input. So I'm going to write system.out.println. Inside the bracket, I'm going to write invalid input. And I will terminate my program here. So I will write system.exit as 0 and finish the program, finish the main and finish the class. Now let's go inside and do the work if it is a valid sentence. The first thing I told today is that I'm going to use string tokenizer. So I'm going to use a string tokenizer class inside of it. So I'm going to write over here as string tokenizer. Okay, string tokenizer, please see carefully, S and T is capital, creating an object of it as ST equal to new same repetition string tokenizer. Okay, again the bracket is passing the variable where the sentence is being picked up and the delimiters that is separated them. So they are separated by space, but the last sentence is being separated by full stop or question mark or exclamation mark. So I'm putting all of them together, closing it, semicolon I'm giving. Now I'm picking up the words. So I'm writing while st dot has, where h is small, more token. Sorry, I will use more elements. Okay. Then those elements will going to be passed inside the array token as in the form of sc.next token. So directly all the words will be transferred into the array of string. Now first thing we will do over here is the bubble sort, okay, as per the word length, because that is my first criteria. Okay, to do that I am taking an extra temporary variable string temp and then writing the for loop. So I'm taking variable as int as I as 0, I less than C, semicolon I plus plus. As here I'm using bubble sort technique. If you want, you can use selection sort technique also. That's up to your choice. Next, inside a nested for loop, int j equal to 1, j less than in the bracket c minus I, semicolon, with the then j plus plus. I'll open it, I'll check if the token j minus 1 position length, as I have to sort lengthwise, has anywhere is a greater length than the j token jth position. Okay, then I have to swap the elements. So I am writing swap elements. So how do I swap with the temporary variable? So I write temp token j minus 1, semicolon, next line token j minus 1 is now empty, which will store the value of token j. Next line token j will now store the value of temp. Okay, once I finished, I will close the loop of if bracket and both the for loop. As I'm done with this part, so first sorting is complete. Now I am going to do the alphabetical sorting. Okay, so for alphabetical sorting, both of my loop will going to be same. Okay, and this condition will going to be same also with equal to, and swapping also I required. So what I'm doing is that I'm making a copy paste, as I don't need to write back again. Here if both of them has the same length, if so rather than greater than sign, we are going to give e double equal to sign. If that is valid, then I have to use over here another more comparing statement of alphabetical sort. So I will write if token j minus 1 dot compare to function is where what I'm using over here. Compare to with token j is greater than over here as 0, then my swapping element work will going to happen. So at the end, you can say 4 of the brackets are going to be closed. One for this if, second this if, third a for loop, and fourth the outer for loop. Now after I finished it, I have to print. So I can write final printing. Okay. So for the final printing, I'm running a loop as int k equal to 0, k less than c as k plus plus, and then writing as system dot out dot println and then token with k plus double quotation, giving the space and finishing it. Now the first if is going to be closed over here. The else part is printed. Now nowhere I required that variable x, so I'm just deleting it as I don't require it anymore. Now let's look for the errors. So I'm compiling it. Okay, here is the mistake. Incompatible type. Yes, the sentence is going to be accepted through sc.nextLine. Okay, cannot find the symbol for sc.nextToken. So it is going to be st, not sc, because here my string tokenizer object is st. Okay, compile, no syntax error I'm getting. So now I'm closing it and running the program. So I'm giving void main, all in caps lock I'm going to give. If I don't give in caps lock, it will show me error, and as per the question it's mentioned to be in the caps lock. So one quote is self help is the best help with a full stop. So is the best help help self. So here actually the problem is that inside while printing I gave println. Now I'm just removing it and compiling it back again, running it. Self help is the best help. Invalid input because I have not given that full stop at the end. So running back again, self help is the best help with a full stop. So is the best help help self. So whatever the result I'm supposed to get, I'm getting the exact result for it. Okay, we can see for any other example, which is be kind to others. So let's look for that example. Let's run to it. Be kind to others. Even I can give a question mark, though it is not a question mark segment. Okay. So be to kind others, as B and 2 both are same length, has been sorted alphabetically. B is at the first and then 2O. So whatever the result we are getting is as per the answer that is present, and we must try it with another input which is not present in the question paper. So let's start with writing. Hello, you are, okay, superb in the game, with an exclamation mark. So let's see. In is first, are the has been sorted, and then coming you, then game, hello and superb. So it has been doing the work as it is being required. As I keep saying, in this pandemic situation, please maintain social distancing, keep practicing practical programs, and get back to me with your queries. Thank you very much. Stay safe, stay healthy, and do a little bit practical work always.